Lost in thought, looking into the distance. Staring into nothing or thinking of nothing. Nobody is going to create the exact movement that you have or the exact how you approach your work, how your brush touches the canvas. Like, so some people may look at a work and they'd say, geez, anyone could do that. Like, but behind it, they can't, because they're not going to follow like the movement you have within you. Everyone has a kind of a sound. Do you know what I mean? If you were to pick up a guitar, you're going to make it play in one particular way to suit yourself, or an instrument you don't know how to play. You will make a sound regardless of whether you can play it or not. I suppose it's the same when it comes to painting for people. Look, you could take a picture and look at something, but you're not going to see an abstract image every day of the week. Like, when you look out the window, you see what's there in front of you. But yeah, to create an abstract image, for me anyway, it's as if I'm looking out the window, and that's exactly what I see in a way, like. You know, be it an abstracted image. You know, everything is abstract to a certain point, like, you know, nobody's the same in the way, like, so. And it's more of an expression of what goes on during the day, be it a face lost in a landscape, as if you're looking into the distance and what you're seeing is actually your mind's view in the distance, like an abstracted landscape in a way, like. So a lot of the work is composed of that, really. Well, the large works, I love painting big. I absolutely fucking love it. Maybe it's just, maybe it's part of the ego again. But yeah, it's really, really attracted to when you come in and you see a big empty piece. I don't know, some people may seem daunted as regards putting the first line on or putting the first mark or selecting the color and everything or what image you want to get through. But no, I don't find that daunting. I actually find that fairly exciting when you start off a new work, like. The larger work, it's sometimes it takes a route of its own in a way, like, as if there's something automatic about it, you know what I mean? You get into the flow of it and you keep going and going. It's with the bigger works, like you'd be going back at them and back at them. There's months and months of work that go into them. So yeah, to get to the finished product is fairly good, like, it's special, like. But there is a certain amount of flow to it, like, it takes over, you know, the work or the image takes control of you in a way, like, you know, and then all of a sudden you've reached the end. This one has been going on for quite a while, like. It's actually started last December, and it's only kind of, it's near enough finished. I kind of had to cover it up for a while when I was working on the smaller works, but as soon as I took the cover off it and it revealed itself to be finished in a way, like, you know, as if it was hidden and now it's ready to be finished. These is kind of like the endless possibilities. They're like a chessboard, you have 64 pieces or 64 squares, and the combinations are endless to a particular game. This is representative of a game of chess in a way. It's just, I suppose it is the endless possibilities when you start something, like, it's still to be finished, obviously. Still a few pieces missing. So yeah, it's the endless possibilities, really. For the smaller ones, obviously, you're using a brush and a palette knife and everything else. Like, the main of my painting stuff is out home at the moment because I'm working on the small stuff. So no, there's no set piece. There could be anything. There could be a fire exit sign. Like, there's loads of them to cover a bigger space, like, you know. I suppose there would be longer tools, like a painter's edge, you know, for the straight edge. They vary in lengths. They give a good scrape to it. They add depth, and then there's layers and layers and layers. And then you kind of remove some to reveal the earlier layers that are there. It's all like a learning experience in a way, like, and you remember the different layers and the different ideas that led to the finished product, and you kind of reveal parts of them when you do scrape away the layers and everything. So yeah, there's no set pattern, or there's no technique, the same technique that goes into it, like. sometimes it, the ego, your ego, everyone has an ego to a certain extent. It's how you want people to think of your work. But if to get rid of your ego, you don't really mind how people interpret your work, as long as they do, as long as they interact with your work to a certain extent, or if they walked past it and took a second look. Do you know what I mean? It's how much of your ego is in your work, like.